I'm holding on your rope, got me 10 feet off the ground.
My name is Jacqueline Saburido. This is a picture of me before I was hit by a drunk driver. Before the car caught fire. Before two of my friends died. Before I needed more than 40 operations. This is me when my life was just like anyone else in college. This is me after being hit by a drunk driver.
I went from a football field on Friday to a prison cell on Sunday. That quick. Through the choices I made on one Saturday. And so it can happen. I had never been in any trouble before in my life. I had never gotten any DWIs or gotten in trouble with alcohol at all. But the one time that I made that horrible decision, one time that I got in trouble, one time, it was devastating.
The person that caused my accident. Destroyed my life completely.
I'm a normal person. I was a normal high school student. Anybody can come to prison, and anybody can be involved in a drinking and driving collision. It's not something that just happens to alcoholics or the trouble kid. And the fact that drinking and driving isn't a joke. It's not something to play around with. It's real, and these are the consequences. All of a sudden, you're in this whole new world, here you go, and you're by yourself. You're alone. And it's a shock. You always have a correctional officer telling you what to do and when to do it. Everywhere you go, you get strip searched, and make sure you're not bringing anything in or taking anything out where you're not supposed to take it. The lights come on at breakfast at 2 o'clock in the morning and stay on because people come and go. Lights out is at 10:30. It's definitely not like sleeping at home. It's a sparse lifestyle. I probably miss the most of... I miss my family, my friends, people that I've known all my life. They've always been a top priority for me. And something that I've always cared very deeply about. So that is probably the hardest thing to deal with. Knowing what's happened, knowing the damage that I've caused to so many people and so many families, it's something that I can't describe to anybody. And the prison sentence is nothing compared to the life sentence that I'm going to live with knowing what I did. And the consequences of what I did. The loss of life. It didn't have to happen.
Hey.
Yes.
I've got an emergency. I've got a car wreck. I believe it's on 620. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what road I'm on. It's a Yukon and a Blazer. I love that car. That's very selfish right now.
It's okay, Reggie. It's okay.
That was my baby.
I'm sorry.
I went so hard. I did everything to that car. Is everyone okay, do you know?
That's fine, Reggie. I understand how you feel. You know, you
I don't care about my car. Is everyone involved in the accident okay?
I don't know. They haven't told me anything yet.
Oh, my. my God.
What's the matter, Reggie?
It doesn't look like any people are seriously injured, sir, correct, sir? God. You won't answer me, but it doesn't look good.
Okay.
Okay. People look pretty bad.
Okay.
And,
okay. I hear you, Reggie.
You right?
I hear you.
Okay.
Okay, it was just an accident, okay? Okay.
I could have done something. I didn't need to swerve out of the way.
Well, it could have been worse.
They would have compensated back.
Reggie, it could have been worse if you hadn't swerved. Do you know what I'm saying? It could have been worse.
It could have been completely avoided, literally avoided.
Anybody can come to prison. The fact that drinking and driving isn't a joke. It's not something to play around with.
The person that caused my accident destroyed my life completely.